Hello YouTube, this is Lil John 1021, and I felt it was necessary to respond to this video. First off, I want to say I think Intellectual Tuesdays is awesome, and if I had an opportunity to participate, I definitely would. But since I don't, I just wanted to make a few comments based on what was said in the video. So first, I wanted to address a comment about, a young lady made a comment in the video that said today's economic state does not allow for a family to be raised in a single parent home, on a single parent income. And I don't know if this is an Atlanta thing or, maybe the cost of living is higher in Atlanta, but where I'm from, women do it all the time. Single parent incomes can raise families in this economic state. And when she said it doesn't allow for it, I don't believe that's the correct statement, not only because I know women are doing it, but because when it comes down to it, if you're a single parent and you have one income and you have a family to take care of, you will do what you have to do to take care of your family despite the state of the economic, what's going on economically. So at the end of the day, you will do what you have to do to provide for your family, regardless of whether it's an economic boom or an economic bust. So to me, that statement just didn't make sense because the economic state has never dictated whether or not someone would be able to provide for their family at all. And I understand, maybe it may not be easy to get a job, but at the end of the day, you will provide for your family. My mom did it for me. I have family members that are doing it for their kids. I have friends who have parents that do it for them. So I know it's possible. So the next thing I wanted to comment on was there was a single woman who had two boys who said that if she were to ever get married, then she would keep working to provide another income. And she said, if the chips fall, me and my children are still going to be provided for. As as far as being the head of the household, I'll let my husband have that role. And I wanted to comment on that because she kept saying over and over that at the end of the day, she wanted to make sure that she and her kids were provided for. And the way I interpreted it, and I may be wrong, but the way I saw it, I thought that she meant that no matter what, she just wanted herself and her kids to be taken care of, even under the situation of her being married. And at the end of the day, sometimes what people don't realize is that when people get married, it's a union. And in Genesis 2:24, if you wanted to get biblical, it says, for this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and they will become one flesh. So you and your husband are one person, and when you get married, you should love your husband as much as you love your children because y'all are all a family. And so at the end of the day, y'all all a family, and everyone needs to be taken care of. Say something happens and he loses his job, you need to hold yourself down and your kids down, but your husband is just as important. And that's something that I really didn't take from her comment. So I just wanted to comment on that and to make sure that women who do consider themselves independent, when you're in a marriage, you become codependent on each other to hold each other down. And so if she maintains so much independence in a marriage that she is just concerned about herself and her children, then where does that leave her husband? So I hope that makes sense. But I really wanted to get to this certain comment that a woman made, and I wrote it down almost verbatim, but this is what she said. Honestly, I don't think in a boyfriend-girlfriend relationship you can expect for a woman to be submissive. When he makes the commitment to where I know I'm gonna be yours for the rest of your life, then yeah, you can expect for me to change, or we can work on me being submissive. Now to me, I really wanted to respond. because it just did not make sense to me. It didn't make sense to me whatsoever. Because in courtship or dating or engagement, whatever you want to call it, it is a chance for you to scope out this person to see if they are marriage material. So the way I feel about it is, women, you should be in a girlfriend and boyfriend relationship what you feel you should be in a husband and wife relationship. Now, I will say that there are duties of a wife that a girlfriend should not fulfill. I will say that. But if you think about it from any perspective, you think about, you're dating this person and this person is independent. Y'all are dating for years and you finally decide to get married. What makes you think after years of being independent that you're just going to give up that independence and the marriage? Yes, marriage is more serious than a boyfriend-girlfriend relationship, and it may inspire you to want to change, but it is hard to change the person that you are. So when it comes to independent versus submissive, I feel like it's a personality thing. So at the beginning of the relationship, your personality is different than it is in the marriage. You're lying to yourself and you're lying to the other person because you're putting on this mask saying, I'm this independent woman, and then you're just taking it off and you're gonna be, oh, submissive, I'm gonna cook you dinner, I'm gonna, you know, rub your feet and all that other stuff. And to me, that's just fake. If you wanna be submissive in the marriage, then you need practice for that. You need to practice in your singleness being submissive to your boyfriend to a certain extent, so that he honestly knows who you will be in the marriage. Because it's deceiving to be one way while your boyfriend and girlfriend is to be another way when you're husband and wife. And so if you want to be submissive in your marriage, you need to practice that in your singleness and in your courtship so that he can see who you are and he can see the person that he's going to marry is the person that he's going to be with for the rest of their lives. Because marriages end because the person that you were in a boyfriend-girlfriend relationship is not the person that you are in your marriage. So what if a man really wants an independent woman and he sees that that's you in the boyfriend-girlfriend relationship and he says, I love this independent woman. I want to be married to this independent woman. And he marries you and all of a sudden you're all submissive. And to me, that's deceiving. You deceived him and you made him think that this is the person you were going to be when you really weren't. So to me, it just didn't make sense for you to try and change the dynamics of a relationship when you didn't practice that in your boyfriend-girlfriend relationship. So, you know, it just didn't make sense. But another thing I wanted to address, my last point, was I wanted to raise a question. Why do guys really want independent women? And I remember at one point on the radio, there were several songs about independent women, about men who wanted independent women, and perhaps stating the reasons why. And to me, the real reasons why were so that an independent woman provides for herself, and maybe that's attractive. But at the end of the day, why is that attractive to someone? Is it so that you can provide for her less? So that you won't have to do as much, so that you can be lazy. And I don't want us to go on and like fool ourselves into thinking that there are not men who will take advantage of an independent woman. And so I just wanted to raise that question. To me, I feel like lots of men want independent women. They may find it attractive, but at the end of the day, that's less effort, money, and perhaps time that a man will have to invest into a relationship with that woman. So I just wanted to make some comments, and yeah, that's about it. So thank y'all, and see you next time.